Need to replace your power brake booster in WK Jeep Grand Cherokee? Well, today on this episode, we're going through the step-by-step process of replacing the power brake booster on your Jeep Grand Cherokee WK. What's up, Mopar fam? It's ya boy at Fred Easy. What's going on? Today on this episode, we're replacing the power brake booster on a 2008 Jeep Grand Cherokee. Replacing the brake booster on a 2008 Jeep Grand Cherokee should be similar for the WK1 Jeep models from 2005 to 2010. We'll get to the part numbers and symptoms of a failing brake booster at the end of the video, so let's head straight right into how to do this. It's a fairly simple process which only requires a 12mm wrench for the brake lines, a 13mm wrench for the master cylinder retaining nuts, 10mm and 13mm sockets, extensions and ratchet for the retaining nuts, a flathead and Phillips screwdriver for the plastic covering under the dash, and the brake pedal retaining clip. Sweet, now that we got our tools together, first let's pop the hood and disconnect the brake lines on the master cylinder with a 12mm wrench. Next, let's locate the fuse box, remove the 10mm retaining nuts holding it, and remove it away from the master cylinder and power brake booster. This allows us the room to remove both of these items. After that, let's get our 13mm wrench and remove the two 13mm bolts holding the master cylinder and remove it from the engine bay. Now let's grab our flathead and Phillips screwdrivers to remove the plastic panel underneath the dashboard. Right after that, let's remove the retaining clip attaching the brake pedal to the brake booster push rod. Next, let's go ahead and remove the four 13mm retaining nuts holding the power brake booster to the firewall. Now that we have the brake booster loose from the firewall, let's go ahead and disconnect the vacuum line and remove the old brake booster from the engine bay and throw in our brand spanking new one. With the new brake booster in place, let's go ahead and put back our master cylinder. Now with the master cylinder back in, let's go ahead and fasten our brake and vacuum lines. After that, let's go ahead and fasten our fuse box back in place. Next, with everything in the engine bay in place, let's head back under the dash and install our four 13mm brake booster retaining nuts. After that, let's reconnect our brake pedal and brake booster push rod with the pedal retaining clip. Finally, all we have to do is install a plastic panel under the dash and bleed our brakes. Instructions to bleed the brakes are for another episode, but I've provided a link in the description from the Jeep forums. Alright guys, as mentioned at the beginning of the episode, the part number for the power brake boosters for the WK Jeep Grand Cherokees are Mopar number 517-5731-AA. Today we use the aftermarket CARDONE 547-1919. Alright, so the symptoms of a failing brake booster are a high brake pedal position that is hard to press down. You'll experience longer braking distances and a stalling engine while braking. The brake booster uses the vacuum from the engine to provide pressure to the brake booster diaphragm, which is made out of rubber. If the diaphragm is damaged, it is not able to pressurize, the boosting effect will be lost, causing the brake pedal to become hard to press. The loss of the pressure to the master cylinder in turn decreases the braking ability considerably, while the loss of the vacuum causes the engine to stall and be erratic while braking. Alright guys, that's everything. You can also find the instructions in the description below. Thanks for watching everyone. If this helped you out, please hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I would really appreciate it. Take care, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.